All right, opponent Mulligans, we're gonna not do that. This is gonna be a dream hand if we draw another land, because the risk with hands like this is sometimes you can get stuck and see four non-lands and never get there. But this kind of reaffirms the beauty that is Ethervile, as we appear to be going at some kind of control deck. Question is how to play the Sage, because if we upkeep the Sage and we brick its problems, I'm more interested in playing Serum Visions. No, it's actually really interesting, because I'm so scared, I'm terrified of bricking. But if we brick, it's not the end of the world, because we have Serum Visions to power through. Don't want to fall behind, and this gives us a good chance to just be right on track. Yeah, we should, between Serum Visions and Omen Speaker, if it's four spells, we'll get through them. Yeah, it's pretty annoying. However, you know what? It's not that annoying, because what's the fourth Sage? Yeah, it's pretty annoying, but it's not that annoying because I don't mind drawing another Ethervile and just operating strictly on these. We are gonna want to hit a second land at some point, obviously. And if we don't hit a Sky Hussar or an Hour of Need, then we're not actually doing much. But looks like we're playing in some kind of control deck. Could be fairies, could be something else, and that means that the sages are going to be really annoying because the opponent isn't going to want to spend a real spell on them. But they may have to. Okay, and now I just totally blanked on what we left on top of the deck, which is problematic because I'd like to know. Don't remember at all. Serum Visions. We're going to draw Serum Visions. Geist of Saint Traft. Okay. Kind of want to dig for a land again. Two for the Thaumaturge. I'll just draw. Yeah, okay. Yeah, just draw seems good. I'm gonna play the Sage. I feel like we want to get as many bodies in play as we can. There's another land, which is nice. Don't want this other Sage. Another Serum Visions is nice, but let's just get the land. Reason that I played another Sage is I feel like we want as many bodies as possible to throw in front of the Geist. Just throw bodies in front of it. If it gets replaced, that could be problematic, but again, just toss bodies at the problem. See how that goes. God, this deck's a headache to play because there's so much scrying. I was thinking that, yeah, I was thinking to just of just doing the Thaumaturge. This forces the opponent to use a removal, and I was also thinking we would just toss everyone in front of it. I don't want to do that anymore. I think just the Thaumaturge. If it gets killed after blockers, that's fine. We're taking four damage. We can try again next turn. So there's a million ways to play this turn. I don't know. Like, I don't think there's enough time to really min-max the scrying. I think the key is probably playing more and getting better. This kind of implies to me that there's another one of these guys coming down, though. Yeah, okay, well. Also, I'm not going to play the Sage because we don't have to. We're going to keep this on one, I think. And we're going to keep the other one on two. And I'd like to get deeper and use this to find either that, probably the Sky Hussar that we're really looking for. Okay. So, yeah, we have a Murder of Frost on top of our deck, I believe. Watching this pretty bad, but again, I don't know. It's just going to require more playing, I think. Here's the fourth Sage, which I actually think we want. And then Serum Visions again. No, we probably don't want it because it doesn't say Sky Hussar. It digs four, though. Ooh, Void Mage is tasty. No, let's keep both. You know what? Let's try it. I think that we could potentially get the opponent in the hard lock. I'm definitely am worried about that Creeping Tar Pit, though, actually, is probably going to be the finisher for this game. But this game has had too many decisions already. It makes me just wanna go back to playing Mono Red Burn. Something more simple for me, like Living End. Not that it's actually more simple, but something with fewer new decisions. Okay, well, I guess Omen Speaker is coming out. Also, I don't think we want the Sage. No, I think we do want the Sage. Okay, Inquisition is a thing that happens. And then the question is how to block this Geist. Because I'd like to put Omen Speaker and Sage on it, lose only one Sage. However, if we do that and the Sage gets removed, then we're taking four. Another four next turn, and then this Tar Pit is really creeping in there. We'd have a little more insurance that the Geist is going to die if we block it with all the bodies, but not sure I want to do that either. Yeah, definitely my main worry in life is this creeping Tar Pit right now, actually. It has the high potential of creeping across the finish line. Okay, there goes the Martyr of Frost. Oh, actually, the Tar Pit looks to be attacking right now. Yeah, that's problems. So, we don't really have a clean answer to that. Wow, Tar Pit only. Okay, alright. So we're drawing Void Mage. I'm not going to use the Sage because we're about to be in the same position, basically. And I'd like to know more. Oh, this was maybe dumb because. Yeah, this is probably dumb because the opponent's probably not going to cast a spell. Yeah, Void Mage and Serum Visions conflict a fair amount. Yeah, everything about this I did was bad. And we're gonna die. Having accomplished very little to nothing this game, but you live and you learn. Or in this situation, you don't live. And I potentially don't learn either. I'm not really sure what I've learned. Okay, here's the fourth Sage. Can you beat this? Hour of Need. There's our answer. There's our answer, boys. Seven. We're gonna need an Augury Owl to chump the Hour of Need. Gee, this is just so bad. If we were able to see a battlefield thaumaturge, it could maybe do it. All right, and this Void Mage is pretty useless. We're gonna need a land and an Hour of Need. Sage is something that we don't want. So I think that actually, why don't we draw the Hour of Need? We draw the Augury Owl. Scry the Sage to the bottom. Play Serum Visions. Draw Hallowed Fountain. Keep Hour of Need and see what the other card is. I don't know. Or we could bottom Hour of Need, or bottom Sage, bottom Augury. Next turn we draw Hallowed Fountain. That seems better. I want a Serum Visions drawing. We're going to draw the Hour of Need for the turn. Draw Hallowed Fountain for the turn. No. Let's do the Augury Owl thing. Is it right? I don't know. Alright, well. Yeah, if we had something like Grand Architect in this deck, but we don't. That's the other version. Instead, I do like Omen Speaker in this deck. Keep them both on one, yeah. Okay. Oh, what am I doing? We need to get to that Hallowed Fountain this turn. Is that even possible? No, I think I might have done this wrong. Yeah, I don't think we can. Oh, it's Scry 3. I thought it was Scry 2. Wow, this guy's overpowered. I bottom that one. Top this Hour of Need. Top this Hallowed Fountain. Play Serum Visions. bottom this, top this. It's not worth it, guys. Play this. Get in. Bang. The gang. Ship the turn. So there's a difference between this deck when it draws Sky Hussar and when it doesn't draw Sky Hussar. It's... No, we don't want to use this. We need that Hour of Need. I'm ready to just scoop. I don't want to show our attack, though. Because all we're going to do is exile the Tar Pit, give the opponent a 4-4 that's going to kill us. But if we drew another Hour of Need the following turn, then maybe we could win. But I think I'd rather just gracefully exit. Okay, at 6 life. Keep these. I guess we have 2 turns, so not gonna scoop. And we can also get in with this Augurielle on this turn. Hour of Need, his Creeping Tar Pit. And then... And then, yeah. Inquisition, and I'm out. Concede, I'm out. That was an interesting game. These guys would have been game changers. So if things are a bit grindy, then maybe Ranger of Eos and Mist Hall could be good, but we're not really sideboarded for this matchup. We're not really sided for this matchup. The Rangers seem like they could be nice. Not really interested in the Griffin too much. It's just Morlun Haunt and Geist are too much of a clock. It's really not about a grind this matchup, I think, although it could be. As for cutting cards, yeah, this is basically the sideboard. We have our anti, like, Scapeshift pod or whatever, anti-affinity, where we would have to board out our vials, anti-graveyard, and then we have our grind package, which this could be the matchup for, it could not be the matchup for. It's really hard to say. It was so tempo-oriented that game that, yeah, it's hard to say. I think that I'm gonna not do it and not sideboard. It's pretty much either all or nothing. And here we have Sky Hussar. I mean, yeah, we could go down on the Hour of Need Thaumaturge combo here because our hands may be getting picked apart. So I'll try it. I might be wrong. Go down on the combo and go into the grind package. Tick vials up to 4. They often go to 5 anyways, so